dressed in their road red with the white and blue trim. The Vikings of Miami East in the home white with the blue trim. And it's Peterson and Konecki tip up control by the Patriots. Hits Seaman on the drive, goes baseline, runs out of room, throws the shot up, no good. Peterson with a rebound, lost it on the way up, and Konecki gets the rebound. They are letting him play because Seaman drove into some heavy traffic and threw the shot up. Here comes man-to-man pressure for the Patriots. Out front with a Matt Bonnet. Goes to the right wing, Dan Bowman, who is a block, playing it forward on the right sideline. And now out front with the basketball, Unger, pressured by Brinkman. Trying to get some picks. Unger looks to the right side. Konecki and Bowman trying to put stuff inside. Konecki loads up a three. It's going to be short. Rebound inside. Battle for it. Still loose. Coming out of there with it is Miami East in a walking call. Matt Monin got the rebound, but his teammate was kind of not ready for the pass, and he walked with it in the backcourt.
Well, I'll tell you, one of the marks of the tournament trail, the further you go along, the more physical it's become, and right now that's definitely true here. We've seen some real contact already that's not been called.
Seaman, pass up to Greg Rosebrook. He'll take it down the sideline, cross court to Brinkman, and now out front. It is a 1-2-2 zone we're looking at from the team from Miami East. Seaman, pressured out front. They'll spin him around. Rosebrook over to Brinkman. Brinkman cross-court pass. Seaman fakes the three, pulls up from 16, rims out. Rebound inside. Peterson up and in. And the Patriots getting some early board work in and lead it 2-0.
One of the ways you can attack a zone is to take it, shoot the ball, and get your inside people to the board because zones can be vulnerable on those offensive boards.
Konecki working on Van Parson. Left-hand move, kicks it outside. McKinney fakes the three, then back inside to Konecki. Double team, trying to go baseline, loses the ball, and he walks with it again. Patriots collapsed on him like a quicksand in the middle.
You know, we talked about Patrick Henry's offensive balance. This is a good defensive team, and they did a great job of rotating there for help on Konecki.
Seaman to Brinkman in the backcourt against the 2-2-1 full court press. Down the sideline, Rosebrook will drive, slide through, off the glass, missed it. Rebound loose on the key, and pulling it in, Jason Unger. Out and going down court is Unger again. Unger, hesitation move, drives baseline, shut off by the Patriots. Brinkman in particular. On the wing, Konecki bobbled it, now will dribble in. Puts up the shot, bangs it in off the glass. They look like they really want to go to him, and he's a nice dribbler with the ball. Seaman, nice move down the lane, knifes his way through, missed the shot. Konecki with the rebound. Patriots throwing up some shots a little bit. Maybe that they're off balance a little bit in the early going.
Right, but they're also trying to draw contact. It looks like the Patriots want that tempo up a notch or two.
Peterson puts the good D on, and Bowman can't get it in. Peterson already with three rebounds in the ball game. We're tied at two, 5:30 to go in the game. Rosebrook for a three-pointer short. Rebound kicked out, loose on the court, and a foul reaching in on Greg Rosebrook on the loose ball. If Patrick Henry tries to pound it in a little bit more. They are going against a zone, which is tough to get it inside against, but they have been shooting on only one or two passes.
Well, and the key is they really haven't been open, as you mentioned. If they call the contact, it's happened a couple of times, and get to the free throw line, those aren't bad shots. But if they don't call the contact, I think you're right. They've got to set it up and make at least three, four, five passes.
On the wing, Monin gets it inside. Bowman, off-balance shot, gets the roll up and in. 4-2, Miami East with a lead. They look to be a nice, patient ball club on offense. Van Carson gets it to Rosebrook in the corner. He's pressured and steps out of bounds, and they put it over to Miami East.
Tough one in the corner. A Miami East defensive player rotated down and bumped. It looked like Greg Rosebrook out of bounds, but they called Greg for being out of bounds.
It is a trapping defense that's been effective for Miami East. They lead it 4-2. Here comes Monin down the lane, slides through, missed the shot, rebound, knocked out of Peterson's hand, and it's put back up and in by Unger. Patriots are going to have to play a little stronger than they're showing so far. Brinkman to the corner, Seaman saves it. Goes inside and reaching over the top, Monin, no, Seaman comes up the loose ball and gets out of traffic. This Miami East team is scrappy, and they lead it 6-2. Rosebrook slides through, jumper on the way, no good. Rebound, Peterson takes it up and scores. Tony Peterson staying in there and getting the big rebound.
He played a great regional final game as well, but he's one of the reasons that Patrick Henry has become so good. He's been very solid inside.
6-4 lead for Miami East. McKinney fires a three and drains it. He had a man right on him, but put it away. Here's Rosebrook with a breakaway, lays it up and... rims it off. Tip up, no good, and Konecki with a rebound. Patriots have missed a bundle of early shots and are down 9-4 in the first quarter. Not the usual start for Patrick Henry. 3:45 to go first quarter. Seaman almost fouls over the back. McKinney, free throw line, dishes to the baseline. Unger scoops it up, fade away from 10, didn't get it. Rebound, back up, no good, and a ball tipped out of bounds by Miami East. They're not calling anything underneath the glass right now.
Forget inside position. There is no such thing, it looks like. It's just over the back, and whoever gets the ball, it's theirs.
See what Patrick Henry can do offensively. Down 9-4 against the 2-2-1 press. Brinkman hit in the backcourt, gets out of the trouble. Gets it over to Seaman, and now to Brinkman. 3-2 zone for Miami East has been affected so far. Bump again out front. Rosebrook spins it. Fakes, goes to Brinkman. Back in the corner. Seaman for a three-pointer. Got it. Oh, what a big shot for the Patriots. And they close to within two at 9-7.
That's one of the things you can do against the zone. It's a skip pass. You're skipping one player, throwing it over the top of the zone. They got it to Kent for a three attempt.
McKinney in the backcourt. Dribbles through pressure into the front court. Under 3 minutes to go first quarter. McKinney down the lane, dishes to Bowman, double pump, misses the shot. Konecki's rebound, and he is fouled on the attempt back up. The whistle will go against Patrick Henry, and I'm not sure yet who will get the foul. Dave Van Carson, I believe. Two fouls on Patrick Henry. I don't see a foul yet on the Miami East side.
No. A lot of bumping going on. We usually don't do a lot of officiating over here, but it's a very physical basketball game.
Greg Gobrogi is into the Patriot lineup. We'll see Rick Konecki at the line, a very good free throw shooter. 76%. He's a lefty, puts it up and short. Patrick Henry down by two at 9-7, 2:47 to go in the first quarter. Glad you're with us on Sports Radio 103 from the state tournament. Konecki gets one of the two. Full court pressure again. Brinkman will split the defense. Down the lane, pass to the right wing. Seaman for another three, puts it away. And Patrick Henry is tied it at 10 apiece. Good penetration by Brinkman. Forced the defense to collapse on him. We're tied at 10 apiece. Miami East, the Vikings. McKinney with Gobrogi on it. Steps back for a three-pointer. This one's no good. High off the rim. Konecki tips it to keep it alive. Fakes, goes back up, missed the shot. Rebound, knocked out of bounds. Oh, and Konecki all over the back of Peterson, got away with it. They have not even looked at a whistle on the inside. Here's Brian Parker in for Tony Peterson. Tony's doing a great job. He's just got to move him back farther.
I'll tell you what, Konecki made a great rebound on the first attempt, but the second one, he was way over the back.
Ball goes way out front to Konecki. He's a nice player. Unger with it. It's tied at 10 apiece. Miami East getting a lot of second shots. Pass to the left wing. Monin for a long one. No good. Rebound in the key, and Seaman's got this one in traffic. A new man in for Miami East is Jeremy Felix, a sophomore at 6'6". And Seaman is pushed from behind by Monin. And the first foul of the ball game on Miami East.
One of the parts of Patrick Henry. A little slow start from the field, not shooting that well. But they have not been intimidated yet in the tournament, and I don't expect them to start now. They've got their feet back in the ground. They're playing pretty solid right now.
Miami East stays with a 3-2 zone. Kent Seaman out front with it. Now Brian Parker is back in for the Patriots. Seaman trying to direct traffic, gets it off to Gobrogi. Over to Jason Brinkman. Here's Patrick Henry back to the deep left corner. And a foul will be called on Konecki trying to get through a pick by Brian Parker. And coach for Miami East is saying Parker's moving on that pick. That one's a tough call. Who gets to establish the position first is the question.
What Patrick Henry does is they take the ball right out front and they set a back screen against the zone down on the bottom baseline on the left to free Kent Seaman. And the Konecki, I believe it was, tried to go through the pick rather than around the pick.
Gobrogi on the inbound play. Looking, sends it out to Van Carson to the left side. Seaman to the wing. Double pump. Shoots short. Rebound. Gobrogi saves it on the baseline. Puts up the shot. Blocked by Felix. Gobrogi back up. Blocked again. And this rebound loose. Still loose. And Felix comes up with it for Miami East. So the Patriots don't get a shot at that lead basket. We're still tied at 10. Miami East ball. Unger to the right corner. That's Konecki way out on the side. Drives baseline, lays it up, and he is fouled by Brian Parker. And they'll call two-shot foul there. They couldn't get the baseline cut off as Konecki put the ball on the court for the drive.
You know, Dave Krause right now is working on the sideline. I think he wants the officials to start calling some of the hacks and so forth that are going on in the shot attempts. There's just a lot of contact being allowed down into one bucket on field goal attempts.
Konecki rolls the free throw off the rim, and it's still 10-10. 1:13 to go in the first quarter of action from St. John Arena. Konecki's second one will drop. The 11-10 lead for Miami East. Let's see what the Patriots do. Down by one. Brinkman outside to Parker, over to Gobrogi on the left wing. Back out front it goes to Brinkman. This is a spread out zone in a 3-2. Patrick Henry may be able to find some gaps midway up the key if they move the ball well. Alan Axe trying to keep his team looking for Kent Stephen, who's been hot in the first quarter. Brinkman to Gobrogi, faking inside. Dribbles in, has some room, shot is blocked out of bounds. Very active team, Miami East, swatting at the ball as it goes up. They blocked probably three or four shots already.
They basically are daring the officials to call fouls. And Patrick Henry's penetrating, trying to draw something there. Nothing's happened there so far.
Gobrogi lobs it in, and it's stolen. Hunter will take it down court with 41 seconds. Down the lane, layup good. But a foul will be called on Brinkman, who tried to draw the charge. It will not be a shooting foul. It will be Miami East basketball.
Good job by Jason. He went for the charge, got there a little late, but at least fouled him while it was still on the floor, so it's no two-shot foul.
Patrick Henry, though, with four team fouls compared to two for the Miami East Vikings. And here comes Gobrogi out. Greg Rosebrook in. Van Carson gets a breather, and Tony Peterson will check in. Miami East with a one-point lead in the basketball. On it, deep in the corner, under for three, and it's no good. Rebound. Parker tipped it, and Brinkman will pull it in. So the Patriots may get the last shot of the quarter here. 30 seconds to go, and Miami East is going to come out to greet him at half court. Pass over to Seaman. Seaman back to Brinkman, and they want a trap out of it. Brinkman trying to get around the corner. Ball knocked out of his hands, and a reach-in foul on Unger with 18 seconds to go. In the first quarter, it will not be a shooting foul, only the third on Miami East.
We talked about not seeing zones a lot. Not only do you not see zones a lot, this is a different zone, a 1-2 that perhaps Patrick Henry has seen at most one or two times this year.
Ball in the backcourt to Brinkman. 17 seconds to go. Brinkman, bounce pass into the hands of Seaman. Back to Brinkman. Trying to dribble out front, and another foul on Hunger, who's trying to block out front. And the Patriots, going to this type of offense, are helping themselves get to the free throw line a little more.
Miami East is trying to come out and really get pressure with their top three people in the 1-2-2 zone. A lot of bumping going on, and again, they're daring the officials to make that call.
Steve Kirby will be whistled for the foul. Rosebrook looking, gets it in the backcourt to Seaman. Only 10 seconds to go in the quarter. Seaman behind the back dribble, spins. Down to the try to go to the lane, puts up an off-balance shot, got it in with 3 seconds, 2 seconds. The Patriots will lead it as we break for the first quarter. Kent Seaman's off-balance turnaround puts the Patriots up 12-11 as we take a break from St. John Arena. The Patriots with a one-point lead, and we'll be back. While trailing in the key, Felix shot blocked by Parker, knocked out of bounds, and last touch by the team from, they corrected the call. It was off of Kent Seaman, which is the accurate one. They will give it to Miami East. Rod, let's check those numbers first quarter.
Neither team shooting very well. I think kind of typical for a first quarter at St. John's. Miami East, 4-14 from the field, that's 29%. Patrick Henry, 5-16, 31%.
Long bomb from McKinney, no good, and Seaman with a rebound. Seaman down the lane, double team, gets it to Rosebrook, fakes, drives to the wing, in trouble, goes inside to Peterson, leans in, turnaround, up, didn't get it, rebound inside, Parker fakes, gets it under control and scores. Awesome rebound for Brian Parker, and the Patriots are up by three. Down the lane, Unger dishes Kirby, goes up and scores. Nice fast break for Miami East, they come right back to cut it to one. Brinkman down the lane, dishes, Seaman open from 15, bingo. Seaman hit 8 out of 9 in the regional final Full court pressure for the Patriots, and he's on target nicely here, Rod Hersha.
Right now, he looks like he wants the basketball. He can feel his stroke coming.
16-13 Patriots. First half action. McKinney into Felix, the 6'6 player, and he walked with the ball, shuffled his feet. Let's check the early turnover.
Right now, in spite of the fact that both teams are going right at each other, only two turnovers for Patrick Henry the first quarter. Miami East has one additional now here in the second. They have three for the game.
Miami East with a rebound edge of 10-8, and they have taken off the full court press. Patrick Henry will insert Dave Van Carson back in the lineup. 16-13 Patriots, early second quarter action in the Division III state semifinal. Rosebrook on the left wing, out to Kent Seaman. Seaman gets a pick, top of key jumper, no good. Rebound, battle, and it's Konecki to pull it in. And Miami East will bring it out of there, giving the Patriots just one shot that time. Unger to the left side, Seaman got in there almost on the foul, gets it to Kirby. That's that contact. Patriots dishing it out a little now. McKinney gets a pick, can't use the shot. He's their three-point man. Turns the corner, goes to the right wing. Unger fakes the shot, fires from 15 and knocks it in. This Miami East team showing their balance as they connect. 16-15, Van Carson, fadeaway shot on the baseline. Didn't get it, and Konecki with a rebound. And the Vikings can take the lead back with a basket.
The Vikings look like they want to take the tempo and slow it down just a little bit if they can.
There's McKinney's drive, shot blocked by Van Carson, rebound to Rosebrook. Patriots come on the other end. Rosebrook out to Brinkman. Over to Seaman. Kent looking around, sends it back out to Brinkman. Still a 3-2 zone, the feed inside. Parker, turnaround up, no good. Rebound, battle, Parker shot it, he's fouled away up, no call. Rosebrook takes it up, he scores. Parker had his arm amputated, and I think he'll get it put back on with 5:18 to go in the second quarter.
I wasn't even close to getting a ball, a hand on the ball that time. Just took him his arms off right at the elbows.
Bowman loses it on the way up, and it's another turnover on Miami East. The Patriots with a three-point lead get the ball back.
One of the things you've got to be able to do in a game like that is adjust to the physical play of the officials allowed. It looks like Patrick Henry is doing it. They've stepped up their defense a notch. They're doing a little bumping themselves. That's the kind of game it seems it's going to be.
Dave Prowse keeps rotating his big guys. Van Carson, then Peterson, then Parker. They keep rotating in and out. 18-15 lead for the Patriots. Let's see what they do with this possession. Seaman down the lane, missed the shot. Gets the rebound. Leans in, shoots, no good. And it's Bowman with a rebound in traffic for Miami East. Patriots getting some shots inside, but not getting them to drop there. Here comes Miami East, almost a double dribble. Hunger down the lane, feeds off. Bowman loose underneath, shoots, didn't get it. Konecki rebounds it up and in. Konecki with 8 rebounds already, brings the Vikings back to within 1. Rosebrook fakes from the wing, double team, ball knocked loose, Van Carson puts it up and in. Van Carson with that fadeaway, the Patriots back up by 3.
I tell you, Konecki's a player. He can go inside, he can go outside, he's got a nice touch, and he really knows his way around the board.
20-17 Patriots. McKinney around a pick. Rosebrook in his face. Trying to use the pick, fakes the shot, now drive, puts it up from 15, off the mark, but the rebound to Bowman, puts it back up, no good, and it's Peterson with the rebound. And I mean, there was some contact in there. Patriots by 3, Seaman open on the wing, way back out front to Peterson, left side to Rosebrook. Lob back door, Peterson scoops it up, shoots, no good. Gets his own rebound, regroups and scores. Patriots up by 5, biggest lead of the game, 22-17.
And I'll tell you what, right now PH is answering every physical part of the game that Miami East wants to give them, and now they're starting to gain an advantage, it looks like there.
Hunger down the lane, had it knocked loose, drives in, gives it off, Bowman shoots, scores, and he's fouled. And Greg Rosebrook hits the deck. I believe the whistle will go against him. Patriots play good defense, but the ball got into the hands of Bowman, who muffled it up and in, and a big basket for Miami East to close the gap to 3 again.
Jason Unger is a good point guard. You don't know if that pass was out of desperation or out of control, but it was a great feed as he dribbled down the lane. It looked like he didn't have an open alley. He somehow got it to Dan Bowman.
Patrick Henry now with 5 team fouls. Miami East with 4. So they haven't fouled yet in this second quarter. Bowman to try and make a three-point play will miss it, and the rebound to Dave Van Carson. Almost thrown away. Gobrogi's checked in the lineup for Patrick Henry. Patriots are up three with 3:12 to go first half. Gobrogi out on the wing, takes it to Brinkman against the 3-2 zone. Inside pass, Peterson open, lays it up, too strong, no, it's going to go. And the Patriot inside game is starting to work. And now it's a five-point lead for the Patriots at 24-19.
And you see Patrick Henry's balance. You've got to believe Dave Van Carson's having a tough time getting the ball. They're giving him extra attention. What happens? Tony Peterson answers the call.
McKinney inside, and a foul inside on Van Carson. Deflected the ball, but they are going to call the whistle on the inside. And Brian Parker will check in. How many fouls on Dave Van Carson?
I have him for two.
So Dave Trouse has to take him out of there. And next one will put Miami East in the 1-1. Dan Bowman looking, lobs it way out front to Konecki. Konecki in the key. New man in. Shot blocked from behind by Seaman. Rebound taken away by Brinkman. Brinkman will go the other way. Gets around his man and the ball thrown out of bounds. And it's last touch by Miami East. The new man in will try and get a look at it. I believe Craig Moore has checked in for Miami East. Patriot ball. Gobrogi lobs it in the key. Peterson takes it up and didn't get it. Gets his own rebound. No. Loose on the court. Gobrogi's got it. Down the lane. And he's called for a walk. They're going to hand out pads at halftime, I think.
I tell you what, there is some heavy-duty banging going on down in the paint.
And it's going both ways, let me tell you, but that's the facts of state tournament basketball. It's 24-19, Patrick Henry with the lead, but it's Miami East with the ball. McKinney high post to Bowman, back out to Unger. Unger with a drive, slides through, and he's going to be fouled. Jason Brinkman will get him, and that's his second foul. So the Patriots have some problems to look at. Several players with two fouls, and with 2:09 to go, it'll be 1-1 at the line for Jason Unger for Miami East.
You know, one of the things that's got to be puzzling Dave Krause, the foul situation is opposite of what it normally is. Patrick Henry simply has not been able to get the call on their dribble penetration, while Miami East has been successful in getting the call, and now they're getting to the free throw line.
Both teams are dribbling in and driving, and as you would expect, to try and draw some fouls. Unger at the line will have 1-1. Miami East hasn't done that well at the line. This free throw up and in. Unger might be one of the unsung heroes on this team. Nice-looking point guard, and he is a junior, left-hander. They have two lefties on this team. Here comes Matt Monin in for Konecki, who will get a breather with 2:09 to go.
Unger is a nice match of quickness and strength, real strong build.
Now Brinkman will stay in there with two fouls. Could be touchy for the Patriots. This free throw good, too. Patriots are up by three. Up the left side, that's Jason Leib, who's just checked in. Brings it out front to Brinkman. Backside to Leib. Looking into the key, dribbles, cross-court pass, Seaman. Thought about three, brings it back outside. Brinkman into the post. Peterson brings it out to Seaman. Corner jumper, no good. Rebound, Parker's got it. Takes it back up, he's got it. Ryan Parker has come out with a nice first half. Patriots are up by five, 26-21. Full court pressure from the Patriots, dribbling the ball in the backcourt. Craig Moore gets it to Unger, a minute 35 to go, first half. McKinney, double teamed on the wing, gets the ball out front. Monin, left side to Unger, steps back, now drive, and he has to put it away. McKinney on the left side, 1:22 to go, first half. Patriots, ball knocked loose by Brinkman, but grab back. Unger with it out front, gives it over to Monin. Dave Trouse would like to get Brinkman out of there, I think, in the closing second.
He's gone to a 1-2-2 zone himself, which Patrick Henry hasn't played a lot of, but I think he's doing that to try and protect some of his people.
Monin for a long one on the way. That one is good. Big basket for Miami East. With a minute to go in the first half, Patriots lead is three, 26-23. Patriots may hold it for a last shot here, especially with their foul trouble. Brinkman gets it inside to Peterson, back out to Brinkman. 46 seconds and counting. Patriots will just hold it. Now Miami East will come after him. Brinkman double-teamed and over to Leib. Cross-court over to Seaman. They'll hold it with 35. Back over to Jason Leib and over to Brinkman. Brinkman with a dribble and over to Kent Seaman. Patrick Henry up by three. 26-23. Keep in mind, this is a Miami East team that's come from behind in three of their tournament ball games. You can never get too far ahead of them. 18 seconds to go and counting. Brinkman sets the play up. Down to 13. On the right wing to Kent Seaman. Back to Brinkman with 10. Around to the left side. Lead cross-court pass. Seaman pulls it in. 5 pulls up from 10. Got it with 3 seconds. With 2. With 1. And that's the end of the first half. Patrick Henry, a late basket, will take a 5-point lead into the locker room. Rod Hirschett with Kent Seaman with the big bucket again.
And Dave, I'll tell you what, when he shot the ball, it looked like he was off balance. There was great defensive pressure. It looked like he almost shot it two hands, and he still got the ball to go down. He's playing with great confidence.
They have not got the score adjusted right, and Patrick Henry's assistants will make sure they do. Timeout from St. John Arena. The score, Patrick Henry 28 and the Vikings 23. Tip-off game of the Boys State Tournament for 1992. I'm Dave Fleck alongside Rod Hirschett, bringing you the action from St. John Arena. Rod, the Patriots with a 28-23 lead. Looked a little tough going in the start, but... gets the zone, backdoor lob, Van Carson puts it up and scores. That play usually works against the man-to-man, but they got it to go against the zone.
I'll tell you, Dave Krause runs that against everything, and he seems to have success with it against everything.
Konecki, baseline move underneath, shoots and scores. Miami East with a nice job of moving with the ball. They've closed the gap to 5 again, 30-25. Rosebrook on the wing with the dribble move. Brings it out to Brinkman, right wing, that's Seaman. Gets it inside Peterson, outside Brinkman, left side to Rosebrook. Patriots work it around against the zone. One thing about both these teams, they have outstanding ball handling, and the turnovers are very low in this ball game despite the defensive pressure.
And it's also a mark of good coaching. Both teams are obviously well coached, they're patient, they're playing unselfish basketball, and they know what they can do and what they can't do.
Seaman deep in the corner, fakes the shot, drives in the lane, puts it off the glass and in. What a move by Seaman. He created the opening, and it puts the Patriots up by 7.
He's listed as 6 foot, but he plays higher than that. That time he extended over one or two players inside for the bucket.
Unger in the lane, shot partially blocked, rebound into the hands of Seaman. Here come the Patriots. Seaman had it knocked out of his hands and stolen. Great defensive play by Miami East. That could have been a real crusher of a play if the Patriots score there. Konecki on the perimeter, outside Monin, deep left wing. They leave McKinney open, but he's covered up in a hurry. Big battle inside, and they're going to call a foul between Van Carson and Konecki, and it's a third on Van Carson. A real battle inside, and that's trouble for the Patriots. And Brian Parker will have to check in.
Tough call for the Patriots. You could have flipped a coin. I couldn't tell who was pushing harder, but, you know, a lot of physical play inside for the entire game so far.
Inbounds play goes outside to McKinney for a three, and it's there. Miami East comes right back. They're back within 4 at 32-28. Patriots had a turnover that really cost them. Rosebrook brings it out front. Brinkman goes inside to Parker. Turnaround jump shot, didn't get it. Peterson had the rebound tipped. It's going to go out of bounds, and it's going to go to the Miami East Vikings.
One of the things that Tony Peterson is finding out, it's tough to jump when you have somebody laying on your back. He had good position that time. Looked like he was going to get the board. Simply couldn't get off his feet.
Both of these teams are those come-from-behind varieties, and every play has been answered by the other. Brinkman will have to watch it out front with 2 fouls. Patriots are up by 4, 5:43 to go in the third. Unger with a right-hand dribble, now spins it left, deep in the left corner. That's Monin. He hit the three-pointer that won the regional. Here's McKinney for another three. That one's short. And Parker with a rebound in traffic. Now looks for the outlet pass. Parker's played a big game for the Patriots. McKinney is knocking Brinkman around. Loose ball, kick to the corner. Seaman for three, got it. Brinkman set him up well, and the Patriots up by 7.
Well, I'll tell you what, it looks like it could have been a foul call, but you're glad it wasn't because it resulted in a Patrick Henry three-pointer.
Unger backdoor. Konecki lays it up and scores. Unger is doing the job on the other end for Miami East. They're back within five. Feed into the key. Parker back out to Seaman. Another three. Good again. And the Patriots lead it by 8, 38-30. And Miami East needs a timeout. The Patriots, using their long-range artillery, lead it in the third, 38-30, and we'll come right back. Miami East got a shot off, but it wouldn't drop, and the Patriots, with a Brian Parker rebound, back in business with a 38-30 lead in the third quarter.
They've had some success, Patrick Henry, that is, by lining up on the defensive players in the 1-2-2 set.
Seaman with a double pump shot down the lane. One of those patented shots that put him through the regional. Puts the Patriots up by 10.
I'll tell you what, Kent Seaman is the money man. They go to him and he wants the basketball. He's playing very well right now.
Bowman inside, missed the shot. Rebound knocked loose and out of bounds to Patrick Henry again. The Patriots have the rhythm right now and a 10-point lead.
And the Vikings are doing a better job scoring in transition than they are in the half-court offense right now.
Brinkman down the lane, left wing. Grossbrook for three, didn't get it, and the rebound to McKinney in traffic. So the Patriots come up empty this time down. McKinney in the key, leans in, shoots, and didn't get it. Peterson with a rebound for the Patriots. In trouble in the backcourt, gets it to Brinkman. 40-30 lead for the Patriots. Brinkman whistles it underneath. Parker walked with the ball. Dave Krause is saying, let's get it to the hot man. That's Kent Seaman.
Well, you got to say that. He's hit four in a row, two from threes. You got to say, where in the heck is Kent Seaman, and get the basketball to him? They've had two straight possessions, and they haven't gotten the ball to him. They've got to be aware of that.
McKinney will take a seat for Miami East. He is their three-point threat. Patrick Henry leads it 40-30, midway through the third. Lots of time left in this Division III semifinal at stake. Unger into Konecki's hands. They haven't gotten to him lately. Monin pressured by Seaman. Out front, it'll go to Unger. Crossing the key, Konecki. Nice spin move, shoots and misses, but he draws the foul. They've got to keep the ball out of his hands in the paint. He is dangerous in there.
I do not know, Dave. You're going to have to explain this to me. How Konecki can get that call and nobody else on the floor is getting the call. When there is pressure on somebody's back, we have seen some big hits on dribble penetration inside. Konecki's been able to get to the line three or four times now on that call. No one else has gotten that call.
He misses the free throw, though. Who was the whistle against there? I wasn't sure if it was Peterson or Parker on the inside.
I think it had to be Tony Peterson because there was a four in the number that they signaled with the bench.
Konecki will get one of the two, and the Patriots lead is down to nine. 3:16 to go. Brinkman will be pressured by Unger, spins out of it, goes back deep in the left corner, then into Parker, gets a push, puts up a finger roll, no good. Rebound loose, Seaman's got it, fakes, drives inside, shot rejected out of bounds. And here comes Jason Leib in for Patrick Henry for Brian Parker. 3:03 on the clock, Patriot basketball. Let's see what they can do with the 9-point lead. Grossbrook looking. Ball in the hands of Seaman. Pulls up from 10. Got another one. Kent Seaman puts the Patriots up by 11.
I tell you what, they went three possessions, didn't get the ball in his hands. They've got to see that. He is on a roll right now.
Unger with it out front. Dribbles, gets it over to Monin. Left wing to McKinney, who's back in. They'll go inside to Konecki, double-teamed, and he has to back to the corner. Ball knocked loose. Steal by the Patriots. The defense is up to the task for Patrick Henry. Brinkman down the lane, dishes, leaves, shoots, scores. Patrick Henry on an unbelievable third-quarter roll. And Miami East with another timeout. 2:27 to go in the third. The Patriots explode to a 44-31 lead, and we'll be back. And they found somebody hot with a basketball, Rod, aren't you?
The nature of any good basketball team is when you have somebody on a roll, you got to look for him. Right now, Kent Seaman, 5 for 5 from the field, has 12 points in less than 6 minutes, and he's definitely on the roll. He's carried them to this lead right now.
Brinkman out of there. Here's Unger with a move. Gets it down low. Good pressure. Bobbling the basketball, and it's stolen again by the Patriots. Seaman with a drive. Goes in all the way. Lays it up. Scores, and he's fouled by Unger. Kent Seaman is is turning it loose here at St. John Arena.
Dave, what a bucket. How in the world did he get it? This guy is 6 foot. He cannot weigh more than 140, 145 pounds. He went right through two guys, got hit twice, still got the ball to go down, and now he's at the free throw line. What a performance.
Kent Siemens, Patrick Henry Patriots are up by 15 and maybe more with a free throw. They're finally getting to the free throw line. And it's up and in. 47-31, 2:07 to go in the third. Lots of time left, but the Patriots have been digging in on defense. Miami East will probably go into Konecki's hands. Let's see. Here's Monin with it. Oh, he shoves Seaman, gets away with it. Into Bowman. Back out front to Monin. Fakes with the ball. Seaman knocked it loose, but it's called for a foul. Boy, Seaman took a forearm right to the chest.
Well, in fact, in the previous possession, McKinney, I think, was working desperately to get a shot. He walked twice and never got a call there. Miami East has lost their poise a little bit here.
Hunger with the ball on the corner. Goes inside Konecki. Leans in, shoots, and got it in. Tough shot, but he dropped it in. The big man for Miami East pulls them back to within 14. 47-33. Patriots, will they go to the delay here? Ball inside to Parker. Knock loose. Scramble situation. Saved by Greg Rosebrook. Rosebrook down the wing. Oh, and he's called for an offensive foul as Konecki tried to draw the charge. This Konecki ought to be going into the drama in college, I have a feeling.
That was a tough call, and, you know, it's right in front of us, and I don't know that either one of us agreed with it, but in that situation, Greg should have pulled it out. There was no reason, no purpose in taking the ball to the baseline right now. The key in a game like this is both teams are going to have their spurts. You want to maximize your spurts, minimize there, and I think it's real important for Patrick Henry now to just stabilize the game and keep Miami East from getting back into it.
Unger to McKinney. They're looking for Konecki and looking for him desperately. McKinney lobs it, and Parker tips it away and steals it. Patriots with the ball, a minute 14 to go. Seaman down court, he's got Parker. Bobbled the ball and lost it, and then he fouled in the backcourt. Patriots had a fast break opportunity, but couldn't quite execute it there. But they're still playing the solid defense.
Alan, what can happen here is a team plays so well over a stretch that they start thinking about the game and thinking about the score, and perhaps that's what's happening right here. Brian Parker simply tried to go before he caught the basketball.
Miami East with the ball. A minute 5 to go in the third. They're down by 14. Unger gets it to McKinney. They're looking for Konecki again. McKinney, baseline, brings it back out. There's Conan on the point. Left wing to Unger. Unger to McKinney. Leave is on him. Feet inside. Bowman loses it. Back out to McKinney. 47 seconds to go. McKinney fadeaway. Up and in. Miami East gets a big basket. And with 39 seconds to go, Alan Maxink gets some pressure on Kent Seaman. Seaman with the ball. Patriots are up by 12. Seaman in the front court. Gets it over to Gobrogi and out to Seaman. 27 seconds to go. Over to Brian Parker. Into the key to lead. Leans in. Ball for a walk. With 21 seconds to go, the Patriots getting called for some turnover.
Tough call because it looked like the official was blocked out. Jason Leap still had his dribble, was dribbling it, still called for the travel. But again, he was making a penetration against two people. No need to make that dribble penetration. They're going for one shot.
16 or 6 turnovers on Patrick Henry in this quarter. Hunger into Bowman. Double team, lobs it into Konecki. And the ball knocked out of his hands, out of bounds by Seaman with 8 seconds to go. That's a big play for the Patriots. Konecki was measuring up to put in a turnaround jumper. If Miami East gets a bucket here, the momentum will be back in their favor. Ball picked off by Seaman. 6 seconds. 5 seconds. Seaman on the break. Down the lane. Lays it up and scores. Patrick Henry got a basket at the buzzer again. And they lead it by 12 as Seaman takes the Patriots into the fourth quarter at 49-35. Patriots up by 14. Unger with the dribble. Wants to go to the wing, can't do it, gets it over to Konecki. Van Carson pressuring him, nice move by Konecki. Fake, flips the ball inside, and it's thrown away, but out of bounds to Miami East. Rod, let's check the third quarter.
First of all, Miami East, 5 of 10 from the field, 50%, 1 of 2 from the line, 50%. Not bad, but they ran into a Kent Seaman onslaught. Kent had 17 points in the third quarter, 9 of 12 from the field, 75%, a perfect 1 for 1 from the line. Kent didn't miss a shot.
Turnovers through three quarters.
As you mentioned, Patrick Henry had five or six turnovers in the third quarter alone, eight turnovers. Otherwise, the score might be more than it is. Miami East also has eight turnovers, as they had four that quarter.
Dan Bowman fouled and goes to the line and hits it. Tony Peterson picked up the foul for Patrick Henry. The team foul differential is a real lopsided affair. Patrick Henry has six. Miami East has only one. Bowman misses the free throw and tips it outside. It's Konecki. Outside, it'll go. Rebounding 25-16 in favor of the Patriots. McKinney looking inside for Konecki. They're going to try and draw a foul. McKinney open for the shot. Didn't get it. Rebound inside, and it's pulled away by Unger. Miami East attacking the glass. And an offensive foul as Konecki knocks Van Carson to the floor. There he is acting against, saying it was a defensive foul. But they will whistle it on Konecki.
Well, Dave, I don't know if you were watching, but Konecki, that's the third guy Konecki's knocked over in this quarter. And the last time it was off the ball, so evidently the officials didn't see it, but he is playing very physical inside.
13-point lead for the Patriots. Dave Van Carson checking his cheek, the recipient of that elbow. Patrick Henry with the lead in the fourth quarter. Van Carson brings it back out. Let's see if the Patriots play patiently here. It's man-to-man defense for Miami East. Brinkman with a drive, back over to Leib, open from 10, set, shoots and scores. Leib connects, and the Patriots have taken the lead by 15.
Dave, I'm not sure, but it may be a box and one or a triangle and two, because they're guarding Kent Seaman man-to-man, but Jason Leib, as you noted, was wide open because they were playing a zone on top.
Konecki, nice defense for the Patriots. Outside to McKinney, his three-pointer up and rims out. Konecki with a rebound, up and in. Hold it over the top of one of the Patriots, and they're back within 13. Down the lane, Brinkman dishes left side. Leib fakes the shot. In trouble, and a foul on the arm by Unger. You could hear that one maybe on radio. And that will be a third team foul on Miami East. Patriots want to get to that line badly. 6:27 to go. Patrick Henry up by 13.
The most impressive thing about this game, if you're a Patriots fan, is the fact they have a 13-point lead and they've only shot one free throw. Normally a major source of points for the Patriots for the entire game.
Rosebrook will try and throw it in. Deep in the backcourt, it goes to Brinkman. Looks like it's back to a 1-3-1 trap now. We're getting a look from this team from Miami East. Feed to Van Carson. Banks goes baseline. He's fouled by Monin. And the Patriots are getting Miami East to do just what they want, and that is start to reach in as they drive with the basketball.
Well, and the other thing is, if you're Miami East, you're going to have to get it to round seven fouls pretty quick, because if this game progresses as it is right now, they're going to have to get Patrick Henry to the free throw line eventually.
Rosebrook way out front to Seaman. Right side to Brinkman. To the right corner. Rosebrook for a three. Way off the mark. Van Carson rebounds it. Reverse layup is good. He went at it on the second time up and got it in, and the Patriots back up by 15. Rosebrook might say that was a pass, but Van Carson knew what to do with it. Pass on the wing. Konecki way away from the basket. They'll give him some room. Here's Monin driving on Seaman. Brings it outside. Kirby whistles a pass to Bowman. Fadeaway blocked by Peterson and taken away by Peterson. Here's Brinkman. Ball tipped out of his hand. Seaman scoops it in. Dishes to Rosebrook. Lays it up. Scores and it's fouled. Seaman got it to Rosebrook for a three-point play. And Patrick Henry's biggest lead on the board, 55-38.
I'll tell you what, Dave. Kent Seaman has done it all in the second half. He had a great first half, but he has scored. He's shot threes. He's dribble penetrated. And he finished that one off with a tremendous pass when the double team rotated down on the baseline to stop him.
Miami East needs a timeout again. In the fourth quarter, it's the Patriots on top by 17. It was from Alan Mack of Miami East. He said, guys, we're in the last stages of what could be our last shot at state, he said, and I'm sure he's going to say, guys, we got to rally. We're down 17. It's got to be now or never. As Rosebrook puts the free throw up and no good, Konecki with the rebound for Miami East. Rod Urshan, they're going to have to come out with something to draw the Patriots into some mistakes in the fourth quarter.
Well, they're going to have to let everything go. Probably a man-to-man, maybe a 1-3-1 trap, but they've got to make something happen defensively.
Unger gets a pass away underneath, and the basket good. It is Dan Bowman, I believe, who scores. Brinkman left wing to Rosebrook. Brings it out front. 5:15 to go. The Patriots have the lead by 15, and they're trying to play a little keep away now against this zone defense. Miami East with five fouls. Siemens through the lane, has some room, lays it up short. Rebound loose, Siemens got it. Drives in the lane, he's fouled on the move. And they're pushing and shoving inside as Miami East getting a little frustrated.
Well, that time Kent Seaman got his own rebound, was almost knocked down twice. No call, finally make dribble penetration. A guy bear hugged him, and they finally got the call.
Next one will be the one and one for the Patriots. Inside bounce to Tony Peterson, the ball tipped out of bounds. Miami East stepping up their pressure. A long way to go yet in this game.
Absolutely. If you're Patrick Henry, you can't look at the scoreboard. You've got to execute. You've got to do your thing. Make time go, come off the clock every single possession.
Seaman to the corner. That's Greg Rosebrook. Back to Seaman. Penetrates the ball, knocked loose. Somebody had him by the arm. And Unger comes out of there with it. And it's stolen by Rosebrook. But back into Monin's hand. To Unger. To the right wing, McKinney thought about three. Now pulls into the key. Left side, Monin bobbled it. Now gets it under control. Inside, Felix sneaks in and scores. Jeremy Felix. And now Miami East back within 13. Ball out front, almost stolen. Peterson to the left corner to Rosebrook. Brings it back out. Patriots in a delay, trying to draw that seventh foul. Feed under to Van Carson. Fake shot up, didn't get it. Rebound, McKinney on the baseline for Miami East. They've picked up the defense, and here come their fans. 55-42, Patrick Henry, but Unger on the move. Long bomb out, top short. Rebound to Greg Rosebrook. In the backcourt, Rosebrook gets it to Brinkman. 3:55 left to go. And here comes Miami East with the pressure again. Seaman up the sideline to the corner to Van Carson. Dribbles out. Brings it out front to Brinkman. Brinkman with a move. Double team. Getting bumped. Gets through it. Feeds it under to Van Carson. Off the glass for two. What a play by Brinkman.
He was hit. He looked like he had a trap, and he stepped right through a very physical trap and got it to wide open Dave Van Carson down on the block.
He was a pinball in between the pockets there for a while. Unger down the lane, dishes to Konecki, and he is fouled by Rosebrook before the shot. Patriot lead is 15 with 3:24 left to go.
And one of the things the Patriots don't want to do is foul. Tough call in that situation. The last two feeds into the post has walked both times, but they haven't called it. That time they saw Greg with a hand on the hip.
I think you'd rather have Konecki shoot free throws than shoot from the floor. And Tony Peterson will check out with a foul. Konecki at the line will get one and one. Patrick Henry on top by 15, but Miami East has rallied from behind in their last three tournament games. Konecki free throw good, 57-43. Patriots looking for their 16th straight win and a berth in the state's final game. Konecki will get them both, so the big guy comes through. He's had a big game. Parker looking, gets it into Van Carson. Back to Parker and over to Brinkman. Full court pressure from Miami East up to Brinkman. No, that is Seaman with it. Gets it out front to Parker. Underneath, oh, throws it away as Van Carson was cutting, and the Patriots turn it over.
And they beat the trap out front, had two guys wide open down on the baseline. Just made a bad pass.
I think they're still looking for the basket, and that's what they need to do against this full court press. Unger will check in. Miami East is back within 13. 3:12 to go. Unger will work it up. Down the lane, spinning, backing in. Outside to McKinney, loses the ball. Rosebrook dives in there to knock it away for Patrick Henry. Inbounds play for Miami East on the right sideline. Monin looking. Gets it out to McKinney. And now over to Unger. Under 3 minutes to go. Unger with a drive in the lane. Jumper up. It is good. Full court pressure and the ball knocked out of bounds by Miami East. An 11-point lead for Patrick Henry. They were up by 17 at one point. It's been shaved down.
Well, and right now I think they're playing as if they have a lead and trying to protect the lead rather than, you know, I think about winning. They just have to take care of the basketball and execute with their pivoting and their ball handling.
Seaman in the backcourt, up to Van Carson, into the frontcourt, but he's going to be trapped. Ball knocked around, loose, and Van Carson gets it away. Gets it up to Seaman, 4-on-2 break. Seaman is fouled on the move. And they'll call McKinney with 2:34 to go in the ball game. And Kent Seaman at the line for 1-1.
I think Dave Van Carson's ready to file assault and battery charges at half court. That was not a normal trap. Dave Van Carson in the flat on his back and made a great pass with two guys right on his arm.
Tony Peterson in for Brian Parker. The clock may be a key here. 2:34 to go. The Patriots want it to run, and Miami East wants it to stop, but they want Patrick Henry to stop scoring. Kent Seaman with a one-and-one for Patrick Henry. Free throw up, and bingo. Kent Seaman on the year, 89% free thrower. 58-46, Patrick Henry. Dave Krause of the Patriots, first ever trip to state, as Seaman will get the roll, and Patrick Henry up by 13. Patriots go back to play defense. Unger will bring it down, goes with a drive, dishes it to McKinney, loses his balance, gets it back. Ball inside, Felix underneath, and Unger shoots and scores. Will the basket count? It will, and Patrick Henry sees that lead slip to 11 again, 59-48, and Konecki back to the line again.
You get in a game like this, it's not over till it's over, as Yogi Berra used to say, and one of the things they can't let happen is you can't foul the guy and let him score the bucket. That time they got there late, you just got to give up an easy two there.
Konecki free throw up and in, and it's a 10-point game. Full court pressure, Peterson looking, gets it in to Greg Rosebrook. Rosebrook up to Brinkman. Two on two, and Brinkman will back it out of there. And they try for the steal, then get it. Seaman over to Brinkman. Brinkman through the defense, and he is fouled. Steve Kirby will reach in with 2:13 on the clock. Patriots up by 10 and back at the free throw line.
You know, the tough thing about playing an offense that takes time off the clock, obviously you're spread out, but you can't be passive. You know, that's a mistake a lot of players make in that situation. You have to be more aggressive and stronger physically than you normally are, and you've got to be ready to attack the basket if the defense is playing out too far.
They're not looking for you to attack the basket. Brinkman nails a big free throw. He's a 72% free thrower, and the Patriot lead is 60-49. Jason with a big game against Wayne Trace in the regional final. His free throw up and in. Patriots back up by 12 now. 61-49. Unger brings it down for Miami East. He'll load up a three. Didn't get it. Rebound. And it's Seaman with it for Patrick Henry. Gets it out. In trouble in the backcourt. Dribbles through. Feeds it left wing. Rosebrook goes in for the layup. Dishes to Peterson. Had it stripped away on the way up. And here comes Miami East out with the basketball. 1:50 left to go. Patriots by 12. Unger down the lane. Dishes. Gets it out to McKinney. Down the lane. Lays it up. Ball is deflected. Loose, and McKinney on the floor. And they're going to call a foul on Patrick Henry's Tony Peterson for pushing McKinney to the floor.
I don't believe it. Tony was not even within a step and a half when the guy went down to the floor. It was a traveling call. The guy dove for the ball, rolled across the floor at least one and a half rolls. Tony was innocently standing a step and a half away, went to get to the ball to tie the guy up, and he's called for the foul.
1:39 left to go. Miami East still with life because the clock stopped and they're shooting free throws. A one and one for Brad McKinney. 61-49 Patriots. McKinney steps up, shoots, and gets it. The Vikings hitting some big free throws here in the second half. The winner of this one will play the winner of game number two between Sparta Highland and Orrville. McKinney to try and cut the lead to 10, and he does. Ball into Brinkman's hands. Up the sideline he goes. Passes over to Rosebrook. Rosebrook under control. The ball knocked free. Loose on the court. Scramble. Seaman picks it up, and he's fouled. And they'll get a whistle on Miami East with a minute 30 to go in the ball game.
The biggest thing the Patrick Henry Patriots need to realize, they don't have to score. And if there's not a wide open opportunity, kick it back out, spread the defense, and make something work there. The two guys, if you're Patrick Henry, especially that you want to see go to the free throw line, are Kent Seaman and Jason Brinkman.
Patrick Henry up by 10, 1:30 left to go. Seaman will have one and one. The Vikings are fighting back with that scrambling defense. Seaman for 1-1. Free throw, bingo. Kent Seaman has played an unbelievable state tournament game here.
Well, you know, last year, a guard from the area, Rob Welch, was the outstanding player in the tournament. Right now, Kent has put in that type of performance tonight, or this morning.
Give him two free throws, and the Patriots are back up by 12. They don't need to foul now. Need that clock to run. Hunger on the point. Down the lane, gets a double team, and then throws it away. Great defense by Seaman to jump in the passing lane and force the turnover with a minute 20 to go. Jason Brinkman saying, guys, spread out. They'll get the ball into Seaman's hands. They're going to have to foul now. Seaman's going to keep it in his hands, I'll bet. And there's a foul on Felix, fouling Kent Seaman with a minute 16 on the clock. And the Patriots up by 12.
The best thing the Patrick Henry Patriots can do, get the ball in number 10's hands and then let the other team try and stop him.
Kent Seaman talking to the official. Don't know quite what it's about. He's got that wrist wrap on that he's carried with him all through the year after the broken wrist early in the season. He'll have 1-1 again, and he puts it in. 64-61 Patriots with a minute 16 to go in the game. Patrick Henry closing on a trip to the final. Seaman, second one, you bet. 65-51, steal by Brinkman in the backcourt. Dishes off to Seaman. He'll lay it up and got it in. Patrick Henry might have put the exclamation point on there. Brinkman steal and a basket for Seaman gives the Patriots a lead by 16. Konecki leans in, shoots, and gets the foul from Tony Peterson with 59 seconds to go. Well, you'd like to avoid a foul, but when he just leans in on you, it's tough to get out of his way.
Well, a tough thing there, and it's happened a minimum of four times. Konecki is either offensively charging or he's drawing a foul. And he has not been called yet for the offensive charge, but there's no question about it. He leans into the defense. There's nothing you can do except stand there and wait for the official's call.
59 seconds to go. Konecki at the line. With the Patriots up by 16, Konecki's free throw gets the roll. He's going to end up with a big game for Miami East, second team All-Ohioan. Boy, Brinkman's steal was big. Gave the Patriots a little extra cushion as Konecki hits the free throw. Peterson into Van Carson's hands. Out to Kent Seaman. Lead pass up ahead to Brinkman. Dishes to Roebrook, lays it up. Block shot and rebounded by Kirby. Here comes Miami East with 49 seconds to go. Down the lane, and Konecki runs into Peterson, and they'll call him for a foul again with 46 seconds to go. And that may be all for Tony Peterson. That's it. Konecki and the Vikings get the clock stopped with 46 seconds to go. This one not over yet.
I used to sound like a stuck record, but they don't need to score unless they have a wide-open layup. They did not have a wide-open layup there. All they had to do was pull it out and get this thing over with. There's a cushion here, but as you said, Miami East has made a living out of coming back in basketball games.
Kevin Rosebrook in for Tony Peterson in the Patriot lineup. A 14-point lead, but Miami East at the line with the clock stopped again.
Well, this is how Patrick Henry knows this. This is how you get back in games like this. Get to the free throw line.
Konecki will miss the free throw. Now, what's amazing, the Patriots have the lead, and they're delaying the clock, and they're not getting to the free throw line. Konecki up and got one of the two. Ball in the hands of Seaman. Dribbles through, still with a basketball. Up the wing, a ball knocked out. Oh, and he was crunched with a double team. Finally, the whistle will go against one of the Miami East Vikings. If Kent comes out of there without shaking his head, he's got a hard noggin.
Happened about 4 feet. It hurt clear over here, Dave. About an 8.5 on the Richter scale. You know, there are a lot of white bodies on this Miami East team, and number 30, the guy that hit him, is one of the whitest bodies of all.
I don't know who got the foul, if it was Unger or Konecki. And Alan Mack is now going to the bench and substituting. He apparently is conceding it's a Patriot win with 41 seconds to go, and Patrick Henry checking out some of the regulars. Checking in, Kevin Prigge, a 6'2 senior for Greg Rosebrook. Joe Brees is in for Dave Van Carson. Greg Gilbrogy is in for Patrick Henry. Kent Seaman at the line with the Patriots up by 13. Kent's free throw up and in. The cords continue to swish from shots from Kent Seaman.
Kent has 38 points right now, David.
38 points and 7 rebounds. 39 points. What a performance from Kent Seaman. And a lot of people besides Patrick Henry fans giving him a standing O here at St. John Arena.
I think his brothers are even giving him a standing O over there. What a performance.
Jason Schultz is in for the Patriots. We're counting down the last 30 seconds here for Patrick Henry with a 15-point lead. Ball inside, shot is short. Schultz the rebound for the Patriots, and he's fouled underneath with 26 seconds to go. We're going to try and get some ticket information somehow to you. The phones, we understand, have been doing a real lightning job back at the studios, and we'll try and get some word to you when we can. Patrick Henry will be in the final against either Sparta Highland or Oroville. Jason Schultz just trying to adjust the scoreboard a bit, and he connects at the free throw line. 70-54, Patriots. The team that got no votes, not a single vote from a person down here for maybe getting a chance to take the title, has at least advanced to the final. Patrick Henry playing the defense. Miami East basketball, long shot rejected, but rebounded by Miami East. Outside, a three-pointer on the way. East connects. Three-pointer is good by Seth Overholzer. Down to 7 seconds to go. Kevin Prigge with 5, with 4, with 3. Prigge shoots, misses, but it's over. Patrick Henry is bound for the final. They'll play in the St. John's Arena Championship on Saturday morning, 11 a.m. for the Division III Championship for the first time in their history. The Patriots win it with a blazing second half. 70-57 final, and we'll come back to tell you all about it at St. John Arena after this timeout.